Coach, you mentioned multiple times this week to the media what it meant to be picked as the homecoming team for Rhode Island. How did it feel to get out of here with a win during their homecoming?
Well, it was good for us to win on the road, and again, I wish we were able to play a cleaner second half. Some of the things we did, some of the coaching decisions we made, not good enough, and we got to clean them up. But I thought the players played really, really hard. I thought they played with a lot of energy. Just excited for them to get a road win and be able to put that in a toolbox, because we're going on the road again next week, and again, we're going to need everything we got.
And you had to be pleased with your running game. Two guys go over 100 yards, two separate 75-plus yard runs. Talk about what it means to get that running game really going as you move on into the next games.
Well, anytime you have two gigantic explosive plays like that, it's hard to lose. And again, I'm thrilled we were able to do it. And I told AP, I said, I don't know if I've ever witnessed a 9.5 second 75 yard run. So maybe this was a first. But again, he's a spark plug. Out he comes, first play, and again he put us on his back, and he leads the way, and he grinded out hard yards, and very, very proud of him. And again, he's a better person than he is a player.
And your defense only gave up 13 points. That was all you needed, with the two 75-yard runs to come away with a win with 14 points against their 13. What did your defense play like today?
I thought we played a great first half. You know, we gave up a sack fumble that they end up getting points on, a shorter field. And then everything else was punts, downs, and turnovers. And we really played a terrific second half, with the exception of the one drive. And that was after we went for it on fourth down, didn't get it. I think a little of the air came out of the balloon. And we got to be more consistent. And again, I'm proud of them. I think we stopped the run. They got some junk runs on the speed sweeps. And again, when that happens, really, it's more a matter of the clock running. And the clock was the enemy at that point. It wasn't the opponent.
And as you mentioned, this is your first win on the road. How much does that mean now that you are going on the road again next week against one of the conference leaders in Towson?
I think anytime you do something, you have the confidence that you can do it again. And Towson certainly is a elite team and a team to be reckoned with. But again, I'm excited. I love coaching the guys I'm coaching. I can't wait to get back to practice tomorrow and try to be 1-0 next week.
All right. Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
We have David Mackle, who really started things off and finished things pretty well. You finished with double-digit tackles and an interception. Talk about your performance.
Basically, my performance today, all week I focused on doing my job and making sure when the ball come my way, making sure that I make the play. And today we played great team defense, which allowed me to make the plays that I made. So that's about it.
You mentioned great team defense. Obviously, the defensive line, we're getting a lot of pressure on the quarterback setting up your interception. What does it mean when the defensive line gets things started, then you guys, the linebackers, kind of get to run free?
When the defensive line is having a good day, that means we get to run around. I mean, a couple plays I made, I was able to shoot gaps. I was able to not be touched by a lineman. And of course, that allowed me to make the tackles that I made. But when the defense playing good and they taking up space and they taking up linemen, it's great for the linebackers and the players falling in behind us.
Now, this is your second straight game with double-digit tackles. Are things starting to slow down for you? You're starting to play really good football.
It ain't that things is starting to slow down for me. It's every week I'm getting stronger, health-wise. My ankles feel good. I was having troubles with my feet, and everything is just starting to come together. I'm able to work harder in practice. So in the games, I mean, it is slowing down. But just me being healthy and getting stronger every week basically contributes to me being able to make the tackles that I make.
So you have one more week to get healthy, and then you play Towson, one of the better teams in this conference. What are you guys doing to prepare for them?
Right now, we just focusing on going in Sunday and doing what we got to do. Starting off good, going in, watching the tape, see what we did wrong, fix the mistakes, and come out Sunday and practice hard for Towson. That's all we can do.
All right, thanks, Mackle.
Thanks a lot.
We're used to seeing you catch passes. Today, you got it done rushing the ball. That's something we're not used to seeing out of you. How fun was that?
Oh, it's a lot of fun when you can do multiple things on the field. And coach just gave me the ball, told me to run, and that's what I did.
Can you take us through your long touchdown run? We thought you were down multiple times. You're dancing on the sideline, making people miss. Take us through that run.
Yeah, like really after the first one, the guys kind of teased me a little bit, say I tripped up and ran out of bounds. So on the second one, I just felt I had to stay in. I seen a guy in my peripheral. He came in. He had me for a little bit. Then once he released me, I just turned on the speed after that.
So you went for over 100 yards rushing. Andrew Pierce also went for over 100 yards rushing and scored three touchdowns. How important is it to see your captain getting it done like that on the ground?
Oh, it's real important. He's he's the guy we look to make plays on offense. And when he has a game like that, usually we win.
And not only that, it opens up play action. You had a big play action catch on that first drive to set up one of his touchdowns. Talk us through that play.
Oh, on that play, we've been working on that all this week in practice. And we just executed. Everybody did their job on that play, and we got it done.
And now you're going back up into Taos. And last time you were there, you had two huge kick returns to kind of ignite the team. How do you plan on igniting the team this time?
Oh, kind of like the same way. Whatever I could do to get the team hyped or to help us win, that's what I'm going to do. And you always got to be ready for a big game like that. So we'll be ready and well prepared.
All right, good luck.
All right, thank you.